Get your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.
To change the advanced fill color and line or border settings for a selected picture in PowerPoint, click the Fill and Line category icon in the Format Picture task pane to show the Fill and Line category groupings. To show the options for setting the selected picture's fill color, click the Fill category grouping to expand it if needed. Note that these settings only apply if the selected picture has a transparent section. If the picture is already completely filled with its own content, then changing these settings makes no visible effect. However, if the selected picture has a transparent background, these settings let you format its background. To remove any fill effect from a selected picture, select the No Fill option in the Fill category. To fill the background of a selected picture with a color you choose, select the Solid Fill option. Then click the Color drop-down button to select the color to use. Then use the Transparency slider to set the level of transparency to apply to the background fill. To fill the background of the picture with a multicolor gradient, select the Gradient Fill option. A gradient is a color that transitions in hue and/or transparency from one angle to another. To apply a preset gradient, select one from the Preset Gradients dropdown. Alternatively, to make your own custom gradient, use the additional buttons and sliders to customize the gradient. To select the type of gradient to use, select a choice from the Type dropdown. Your choices are Linear, which changes colors from one side to another across a straight line, Radial, which changes colors starting from an origin point and then radiates outwards in a circular pattern, Rectangular, which changes color starting from an origin point and then radiates outwards in a rectangular pattern, or Path, which follows the path of a line that you draw. After selecting a type of gradient other than path, then select the specific variation to use from the Direction dropdown. If you selected a linear gradient type, then you may select the angle at which the gradient changes by entering the desired angle in degrees into the Angle spinner box. The Gradient Stop section lets you set the number and appearance of changing points in the gradient's color scheme. At its most basic level, a gradient must have at least two gradient stops. For example, if a gradient changed from black to white in a linear fashion, then it would have at least two gradient stops. You can have more if desired. To change the selected gradient stop's position in the gradient, click and drag it left or right. Alternatively, enter its position as a percentage into the Position spinner box. To set the color of the gradient at the selected point, then use the Color dropdown. To set the brightness of the selected color, use the Brightness slider. To set the transparency level of the color at that point, then use the Transparency slider. To add a new gradient stop to the gradient, click into the gradient line at the spot where you want to place the new gradient stop. Alternatively, click the Add Gradient Stop button to the right of the gradient line. To remove a gradient stop, select the gradient stop to delete. Then click the Remove Gradient Stop button. To set the gradient fill to rotate with the picture if the picture is rotated, check the Rotate with Shape checkbox at the bottom of the task pane. To fill the background of a selected image with a picture or texture, choose the Picture or Texture Fill option button back at the top of the Format Picture task pane in the Fill category options. To apply a preset texture, select a choice from the Texture dropdown. Textures are just preset images included in PowerPoint. To use a picture instead, click the Insert button to open an Insert Picture dialog box. This Insert Picture dialog box provides the same choices as when creating a custom picture bullet in PowerPoint. In this dialog box, click the button for the desired method to use to insert a picture. Then select the desired picture in the associated dialog box or window that appears for the selected picture type. After selecting the picture to use, click the Insert button in the dialog box or window to apply your picture as the background fill. Alternatively, to paste the contents of your clipboard into the picture's background, copy the content to use as the background fill, and then click the Clipboard button in the Format Picture task pane. To set the amount of transparency to apply to the background picture, use the Transparency slider. To tile or repeat the background as a texture, check the Tile Picture as Texture checkbox. To set the amount of horizontal and vertical offset to apply to the tiled background picture, use the Offset X and Offset Y options in the Tiling Options section. To set the percentage of the picture to display in the tiled background, use the Scale X and Scale Y spinner boxes. To set the alignment of the background picture within the main picture, use the Alignment dropdown. To select the type of reflection to apply to the tiled pictures in the background if desired, use the Mirror Type dropdown. Alternatively, to see offset options for the picture instead of tiling the background picture, uncheck the Tile Picture as Texture checkbox. Then input the percentage by which the picture should be offset from the selected side by using the Offset Left, Offset Right, Offset Top, and Offset Bottom spinner boxes that then appear. To rotate the background with the picture, if the main picture is rotated, check the Rotate with Shape checkbox. To set a pattern fill for the selected picture, choose the Pattern Fill option from the top of the Fill Options section. Then select a desired pattern to use from the choices in the Pattern section. Then use the Foreground Color and Background Color dropdowns to set the desired foreground and background colors to use for the selected fill pattern. To use the Slide Background Fill, select the Slide Background Fill option. The next category grouping in the task pane is Line. As applied to pictures, these settings change the appearance of a selected picture's border. The three options are No Line, Solid Line, or Gradient Line. To not have a border or to remove an existing picture border, select the No Line option. To apply a solid colored line border to a selected picture, select the Solid Line option button. Then select a color for the line border from the Color drop-down button's palette of color choices. To choose from more colors, select the More Colors command at the bottom of the color palette to open a Colors dialog box. This dialog box appears in almost all the places where you can choose a color in Microsoft Office products. You can either click the Standard tab and then select a color in the honeycomb of color choices, or you can click the Custom tab to select a color from the rainbow gradient, and then use the slider to the right to change its darkness or lightness. At the bottom of both tabs, the Transparency slider lets you set the level of transparency to apply. If you opened the color dialog box to select a color, then click the OK button to apply it. You can also use the Transparency slider in the Format Picture task pane to set the transparency level of the selected line color. The options that then follow in the Format Picture task pane are the same for both the solid line choice and the gradient line choice. So let's first examine how to apply a gradient border line and then review the settings that both solid and gradient lines share. To apply a gradient line, Select the Gradient Line option to view a different set of options at the top of the Line category grouping. You can apply a gradient to a border the same way you can apply a gradient as a background fill. So these options should be familiar to you as we just covered them in the Fill section. You can use the same settings within the Line category to create a gradient border. After creating your solid line or gradient line, additional line options that the two styles have in common then appear at the bottom of the Format Picture task pane. To set the width of the line in points, use the Width spinner box. To apply a sketched style, select a style from the Sketched Style dropdown. To apply a multi-line border, use the Compound Type dropdown to select the style of multi-line appearance. To create a dashed or dotted line border, use the Dash Type dropdown to select a style of line to apply. The Cap Type dropdown lets you change the appearance of the ends of lines. This setting is not often used when applying picture borders. To set the appearance of the junction points where two lines meet, like the corners of a picture's border, use the Join Type dropdown. The last few settings are only used when formatting arrow shapes and are grayed out and unavailable when formatting picture borders.
Like what you see? Pick up your free copy of the complete tutorial at www.teachucomp.com/free.